I'll be right there.
Look it, lady. I don't care where you go as long as you go somewhere. And now.
Harsher Armadillos. My brother Dimitri is a keyboard player. I play saxophone. I also handle a lot of the management stuff between me and Dan, the drummer. We do most of the booking and kind of just keeping everybody in line and keeping things going smoothly.
So do you ever get stage fright?
Not really. I've always been a performer, I suppose, whether it's with saxophone or skiing or surfing or whatever else. I've always felt, you know, I was in theater as a child, and I always felt that I enjoyed, you know, being in front of people and talking to people. And
if you were to live in a movie, which one would you want to live in?
Oh man, live in a movie. That's tough. I don't know. Never thought about that. You got me off guard there. I think Easy Rider would be a sweet one. I like the thought of, you know, just riding bikes on the open road and kind of live flying by the seat of your pants and, you know, hopefully not getting killed at the end. But sorry if I just spoiled that movie for anyone. Yeah, kind of riding and living and meeting whoever you meet and taking experiences as they come. I think that would be a pretty cool way to live.
You guys can come up close. Don't be strangers. Come on. You know you want to.
Camden Riley. I play guitar and do pretty much everything in Harsher Armadillo. I am the band. And today I'm gonna take a diversion from being the heart of the everything.
Harsher Armadillo is a, in a serious note, pretty important. Obviously, a huge part of who I am. It's the band that essentially taught me how to play live. The band who essentially taught me how to collaborate, and the band who essentially taught me how to take music seriously on a business front and also on a songwriting front. So it's a chance to collaborate with such a large group of people that are coincidentally and luckily on the same page.
Can you tell me about how music came into your life?
Yeah. Well, I grew up. My father played guitar, which was obviously huge. And around 10 years old, on my birthday after hearing someone who, my father had a pretty good taste in music. So, obviously I grew up on stuff that kind of built the foundation for what I wanted to do and musically, and my dad, is conveniently a great guitarist, so around the age of 10 or so, I asked him to teach me, and, it's been a huge part of who I am since I was about 10. Good amount of time at this point.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, McHenry Architecture here. Here's the footage schedule for the show tonight.
Coming.
We start with the floor and say 3,000 PSI concrete slab grid, 6x6, polyvinyl barrier over Camden Ave.
I don't know if we can pull it off, man.
Oh, I don't know if we can pull it off. Maximum dry anal.
Oh my god.
Maximum dry anal?
Maximum dry anal? It cannot be!
It cannot be!
This interview was filmed in front of a live studio audience. Thanks for coming.
What's it like being famous?
It's... You don't know the struggle that I face. Every day. I have to walk outside. And I have to eat these fucking rice balls. Like I own the fucking place. They say, Cam, You're such a great guitar player. Your songs are so huge. Your voice is so fucking. It's better than Andrea's. Everyone likes you better than Andrea as a singer. You should kick Andrea out. You should just sing all the female parts in her register. And I say, no. I need to eat lamb. I need to play guitar and be me. Andrea, she can be her. I live in LA. I live in what's that guy's name? Who's that actor? I live in Rip Torn's son's old house.